सब्सक्राइब कीजिए हमारे यूट्यूब चैनल शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन लीगल मैटर्स को और दबाइए इस बेल को ताकि आपको मिल सके हमारा वीडियो सबसे पहले और यह बिल्कुल फ्री है। रेडी स्टार्ट। द लर्नेड काउंसिल हैज रिलाइड ऑन सेवरल डिसीजंस ऑफ डिफरेंट हाई कोर्ट्स इवन ऑफ दिस कोर्ट टू कंटेंड that the provisions of section 141 of the civil procedure code apply to a testamentary suit. The learned counsel also referred to several orders made by this court granting interim orders in testamentary suits in relation to the properties. The learned counsel also relied on a judgment of the learned single judge of the Calcutta High Court in the case of Priyamvada Devi Birla versus Lakshmi Devi Nevar and another 2005 4 CHN 544. Perusal of the provisions of section 247 shows that the court itself does not, while making an order for appointment of administrator, decide what is the property left behind by the deceased, and it does not make any interim order in relation to the property. Thus, to my mind, it is clear that in the act itself there is no provision made authorizing testamentary court to make interim order as a matter of course for protection of the property during the pendency of the testamentary suit. No doubt, not only section 141 but the entire civil procedure code is applicable to a testamentary suit. Therefore, the power of the court under order 39 would also be available to the court for making orders of temporary injunction. But for making an order of temporary injunction under order 39, the property in relation to which the order is sought has to be subject matter of the suit. Similar is the case with the provisions of order 40 in relation to appointment of the receiver. An order of temporary injunction or an order appointing the receiver can be made by the court only in relation to the property which is subject matter of the suit. A civil court can also make interim order in relation to such property is necessary to be made to secure the execution of the decree that the court may pass in the suit. However, in a testamentary suit, property left behind by the deceased is not the subject matter of the testamentary suit. The nature of decree that the testamentary court passes is such that to secure its execution, it is not necessary for the court to make any interim order in relation to any property. The division bench of the Patna High Court in its judgment in the case Kashinath Singh versus Dulhin Guljari Kuwer AIR 1941 Patna 475 has observed thus. It is thus clear that the Supreme Court has held that the proposition of law which is laid down by the division bench of the Patna High Court in its judgment in Kashinath Singh case is undisputable. The Supreme Court has also observed that the testamentary court has no jurisdiction to go into the question of title of the deceased to the property mentioned in the will. It is thus clear that in a testamentary suit, the property which is mentioned in the will are property which may be or may not be left behind by the deceased is not the subject matter of the testamentary suit, and therefore, in my opinion, in exercise of its power under Civil Procedure Code, the court would not be entitled to make an interim order in relation to protection of the property unless an order is required to be made by the court in the peculiar circumstances under Part 7 of the Act. Stop.